Hello guys, this is Sim Spencer. I just wanted to do a quick update kind of video, because a few things are going on right now and I just wanted to update you guys. Oh god, why am I lagging so bad? Hold on, just need to check something. Why is that out loud? Stop that. Yeah, it doesn't really matter because I'm just going to kind of sit here. I just needed some sort of like place to record. I have made a decision that I am going to stop using Fraps as my main recording software. I bought Fraps a while ago, I think when I first started my channel, and before I even say anything, I'm not telling anyone not to get Fraps. Fraps is an awesome product that you could use if you really want to do some high quality gameplay recording. But the thing is though, for me, as a casual gamer, I don't really find the need for that high of a quality, also that high of a file size. For most of you, you guys may know that for me, I have two computers. I have one that I edit on, which is my Mac, and I have one that I record on, which is my main gaming PC that I built. I have to transfer recorded files from my gaming computer to my Mac for me to edit. And the problem with this is that iMovie, which is what I use right now, does not accept any other files besides .mov or .mov and a few other video files. And normally what I do is I convert, sorry for the clicking, I'm playing around with something. Normally what I'll do is I will open my converter suite and I will convert my raw Fraps video, which is usually 70 to 80 gigabytes a size. I know, that's crazy, but I'm telling you. Fraps tends to record at very high file sizes, which isn't always necessary. But it's a necessary part of the program, so if you're going to use that, you need to be able to handle large file sizes. I, on the other hand, have trouble when I have to record something and then convert it, and then I have to send it over my router to get to my Mac. And I know it sounds overcomplicated, but this is really the only way I can do it. So I have decided that I'm going to cut out the converter process completely by switching to a different program. And like I said, I'm not discouraging anyone from buying Fraps. Like I said, it's a great program. It's so easy to use. The problem is that it records at very high file sizes. You might be wondering, oh, you just did a video on XSplit, why aren't you getting that? The reason why I'm not getting XSplit right now is mostly because it has features that I don't really need, and there are much more simple programs out there that I can use. I'm not disapproving of XSplit. I think it's a great program. It's great for streaming. I don't stream, and I'm not going to pay extra money for a streaming program when, you know, I don't need the streaming capabilities. XSplit is great for if people who, instead of YouTube, they do Twitch or Justin.tv. That's great for that because it's a great streaming program. But for me, it's not the best choice. I'm gonna fly because I don't like monsters. Now, you might be wondering, oh, okay, well, you're using something other than Fraps and XSplit right now. What could it be? I'm currently using a program called Open Broadcaster Software, or OBS is more commonly known. OBS is a free and open source program that allows you to record and stream at the same program more so. Like I said before, it's open source, so that means that it's free. And free things are always good because it doesn't cost extra money. Fraps costs maybe like $30, and XSplit you actually pay for monthly, which I kind of dislike about it. That's the only thing I dislike about XSplit, is that you have to pay monthly, almost like you're subscribing to it, whereas Fraps you pay one time, and then that's it. Both are good software, but not for me. So, Open Broadcaster software is completely free, it's open source, and people are constantly working on it to improve it because it's open source. It's mainly used for streaming, but it does have recording capabilities, and I read online that the people, like the distributors of Open Broadcaster Software, blah, I'm just going to refer to it as OBS from now on, are trying to add in more recording capabilities to OBS, which is pretty good, especially for people who use it only for recording. I am using it right now, and the primary reason why I'm using it is, one, it's free, so I don't have to spend extra money for something that I could have spent on in the first place. I would buy something similar to Bandicam or even XSplit, but I already spent money on Fraps, and I feel like if I'm not going to use that money, I might as well get something that's free. So I'm almost getting my money back, if you think about it. I will put a link for all the recording softwares that I mentioned today. Like I said, all of them are great software. Fraps is great for if you want to do really high definition recording or really high performance recording. XSplit is great for if you want to stream like a pro. XSplit also does have recording capabilities, which is primarily why I'd use it, but like I said, it's more towards the streaming part. And then finally, OBS, which is free, and I'll put a link for all those down below. Thank you so much for watching. Also, a quick update. Let me open up my sparkling water, because I'm posh like that. Ah, delicious. Okay. I have officially pre-ordered The Sims 4. The reason why I was delayed, I said on Thursday that I was getting it on Friday, and the problem was I had a complication with purchasing it, so I waited until yesterday, and now it is in my Origin library. Now, I cannot access it yet because EA hasn't made it available. However, they have made it so you can see when it gets released. It's in your library, technically, but it's not downloaded. Basically, it automatically downloads on August 29th, and then comes September 2nd. Actually, it comes at midnight on September 2nd, which is really cool. Not going into September 3rd, I mean. You guys know what I mean. Midnight of the previous day. And then it becomes accessible, and I'm hoping that I can do a recording at midnight where I can, as soon as I get it, I can start to record and do my first impressions. I'll probably be tired. I'll need coffee. I don't know if I'm going to do that, but if I do, I will post it. And one more thing, I've actually figured out how I can schedule uploads. So I have decided that my uploading schedule is going to be every Wednesday. I might adjust it here or there depending on what time of the year it is. If it's a time of the year where I'm off from school, I may adjust that. But for the most part, it'll be constant every single Wednesday. I'll try to keep it at that. For me, scheduling these uploads is a lot more helpful because I have other stuff I need to do, and I'll probably record on the weekends and then set it to upload on Wednesday. So that's probably what I'm gonna do. I might change it, but if I do, I'll let you guys know as soon as I figure it out. Thank you so much for watching. I'm not gonna be like, leave a like. I'm not gonna do all that because you guys don't need to do all that because this was just an announcement. But if you do, feel free. Like I said, subscribe to see some Sims 4 content in the future. I will be getting that pretty soon. It comes out on September 2nd. And thank you so much for watching. Bye!